Okay, so we have all of our strips cut out and our water, and my belly is nice and greasy so it don't stick. Okay, so we finished our cast. By the way, the kind that we used was the pregnancy belly kit. It's by Proud Body. We actually purchased this one at Burlington in the baby section. It was $29.99, I believe. Yep. You can also get them at Babies R Us and a couple of places like that. I'm sure craft stores have them as well. So anyways, we did this last night. This was the belly casting lubricant that you rub all over your belly before you start putting it on. That way it'll come up properly without, pulling hair, sticking or tearing, cracking, that kind of thing. So this is the finished product, and it looks really rough right now because it's still drying. It has to dry for quite a few more hours. And then we're going to sand it down and paint it. So I'll be back to show you that. So this is the belly all dry. You see, so I have it outside where I can work on it. I have, let's see. I have a sanding block, so I'm going to sand it down because you can still see really bad the marks, which I'm not sure if I'll be able to get them all out, but hopefully I'll be able to make it a little bit smoother than it is because it's pretty rough looking. And then also I have some scissors because I'm going to cut off all the edges because this part was actually wrapped around my backside. The angle that this one is done, I didn't stand. I kind of leaned back in the chair, so I mean, if you look at it like that, you can kind of tell that's how it was. And then also, if you notice, I don't have a spot where my belly button pokes out, and that's because my belly button actually don't stick out. It never pops out at all. It didn't with my first either. So, all right, and then some other things that I'm going to use to decorate with and everything. First of all, what I'm going to do is I have a basic paint and primer. So after I sand it down, I'm going to use this to prime it, and it'll give it a solid white, and I'll let that dry. For the inside, I have this matte finish, which basically it's a protective matte, so, and it's non-glossy. It'll basically keep it from, doing any weird things like molding or anything like that, since we did use, it was used with water and the belly lubricant that was put on my belly and everything. That way it don't mold or anything. And then we're actually going to paint, be painting the whole cast once we get to that point, with this color of pink. And this is just acrylic paint. So it should be good for that. So I got two of those. I really don't think I'll need one of them, but just in case. I also picked up a black and a white. It's a painter's marker. So I was thinking for an idea is I could maybe put a cute saying across it. And eventually I'm going to put her feet prints on it, I believe. Or I could put her name across it, whichever. And then these are the kind of brushes I'm going to be using to paint it with. That way, instead of regular paint brushes, that way I don't get the streaks. And then I got some ribbons that I'm going to tie around the top for a bow. Okay, so now that my primer is completely dried, we're going to start painting it the pink. Unfortunately, I couldn't really sand out a lot of these. It's so hard. So hopefully it won't turn out too bad. Colton's going to be my little assistant. So we're using acrylic paint. So I'll put that there. Right, and then we're just going to start painting. And I'll probably do a couple layers.
Take time to realize that your warmth is crashing down on it.
All right, so I'm going to use a hot glue gun, glue
Take
sticks,
time
to
to
put on
realize
some ribbons. around the top up here. And then I have, this is a fabric glue that I am actually going to use to put around all the edges so it don't come detached. And then I'm still debating right thing. I don't want to mess it up.
If you just realize what I just realized, then we'd be perfect for each other and we'll never find another. Just realize.